I think we should be live. So I have hello everyone in the chat, hello flat earthers, hello globers and space believers. Everyone is welcome. I have with me two awesome people. Crow and Martin is here. Big thanks both for joining.
Thank you for inviting me.
I'm very happy to chat with you both again.
Thanks, Gio. Thanks for the invite. Awesome to see you, Gio, obviously.
I have spread the link to a few other people also, so maybe some other people will join also. We will see.
Excellent.
Everyone is welcome. If anyone needs the link, you can ask me also. I will post it in the Hangout or in the YouTube chat.
Awesome.
So it's just going to be a random Hangout, nothing special, just talk about some Flat Earth related stuff. Not much I want to point out.
Well, this space is cool and flat Earth is not.
It's a title for the general public, so the general public will be attracted by my genius title.
Excellent.
But then when they look, they will get annoyed and they will thumb down my video. See, I have two thumbs downs already.
Yeah, you started with them, though. I noticed them when I came along. So they were there before anything. So it starts with two thumbs down. Kind of them, isn't it?
No, I just saw it changed, but it doesn't matter. So let's start with one thing I wanted to point out. Like a lot of flat earthers, I don't know, most of you that are here, maybe you are in flat earth for a long time already, maybe not, but I'm into flat earth for like 2 years already now. I searched it on YouTube so many times. Let's see if I can screen share. There's something funny. When I used to look for flat earth videos, I used to go to the YouTube search and search for flat earth. Do it. Oops. And then I used to select, show me all the live videos. And usually it was like one video, two videos, three videos sometimes, like 2 years ago. Then it started to go up slowly. And now when you do it, you get like a list of minimum 2 pages all the time. And like everything in this list is like space stuff. Well, you see the two on the top now is flat earth, but usually they are at the end of the list, all the serious flat earth debates or hangouts. But all the stuff you get here is insane. You get all the space stuff, ISS from space, live all the time on different channels. This is one that seems to be up all the time. That's a German channel. Seems to be pretty good, but I don't understand it that good. But even stuff like this, live cams from, what is this? Jackson Hole Town Square, NASA, public education.
Yeah. I followed the Jackson Hole Town Square one for about 10 minutes, Gio.
It's insane. Why do all these things show up? Is it YouTube that promotes it, or is it like if you open some of those? I'm not going to do it right now because I don't want copyright strikes or claims. But if you open most of them, you will never see the keywords flat earth anywhere. Like you can see the description, you can see the title and everything. The word flat usually is not in there. So I wonder why it shows up if you search for flat earth. Like, did YouTube maybe change it so that you see all the Earth ones also right now? I don't know. But it's like, to me, it shows me how they try to hide the flat Earth and how they try to steer people to all the space stuff instead. This list goes on and on. See, you can see the sea and some cars here. If you search for flat Earth live, you can even see a plane.
Oh my God.
That's just one thing I wanted to point out.
Yeah, I've been watching a few of them, Gio, these live streams. There's one of them late at night called P&K.
Yeah.
Malinga or something, and he shows just basically pans in live on the moon. I've actually spoke to him in chat. He was quite pleasant. I've seen two flat earthers in there as well. Funnily enough. Well, but he's not doing any sort of space promoting, he's just panning on the moon. So
yeah. Well, there's always a few good ones, and filming the moon is a good thing. We can learn from it. So
yeah, I said, could you pan in on Tycho Crater for me, please? And he said, no, I'm afraid it'd be way too bright. I said, yeah, it is. So he was quite right. But then he went right out just for me and then panned on the whole moon so he could show how incredibly bright, you know, the Tycho Crater at the bottom is, because it is right sort of dazzling with optics. So yeah, it was really cool to do that for me. So, but not a flat earther. I did come out with, all I said was, if you stare at a full moon, if there's 13,000 satellites up there, by all accounts, you should be seeing at least 300 an hour passing in front of a full moon. Why aren't we? Question mark. And everyone's like, good question. So I was just doing things like that in chat, not to, you know, give myself away too much, lest they hover my name. But yeah, it is something wrong with that. Corrales.
Big thanks also to everyone in the chat. I see a lot of amazing people. Martin, yeah, they are amazing. Dieke from Netherlands, come join.
Yeah. Zika, Zika. Martin D. Zika, Zika.
They are cool. I like that they're very cool. Hangouts now. I used to chat with them a long time ago. Yeah, cool people.
I think it was you that introduced me to Martin. He's such an awesome bloke. Really lovely.
Yeah. Anyway, so I told the most important thing I wanted to say, I said already. So now it's going to be mostly just a random hangout. If you have any topics of anything you want to address or say.
I'm wondering about this this new agenda, what they're painting with Antarctica, because everyone's jumping on the bandwagon. I noticed the whole, you know, the mainstream conspiracy, shall I say, like the likes of, David Wilcox and that, you know, are thinking there's Atlantis being discovered and Agartha may be a reality. For those who don't know Agartha, this is to do with hollow earth theory, which I don't believe you need a ball for. But yeah, they're painting this picture and like getting everyone to think this is a reality down there. You know, when people like Buzz Aldrin helped along, showing him photographs, showing photographs of a pyramid next to his place where he stayed in Antarctica. So I don't know why they're doing that. Obviously, a little bit of keeping us thinking on Antarctica while we stop thinking about the North Pole, maybe. I'm not sure.
I think it's sort of propaganda also to steer people away from Flat Earth, who knows. But yeah, it was funny. I saw it recently that Buzz Aldrin was in Antarctica. That's kind of
funny. I didn't know till they were bringing him out of there, Geo. You know, when he had a bad back or what have you. I didn't hear anything about him going, only coming out of there.
Cool.
You know, they told us Kelly was going, Senator Kelly, and this other, I don't know what Orthodox priest guy. They told us about them, but nothing about Buzz going. I've been following it, so that was unusual.
Big welcome to Chris Truthseeker.
Good evening, gentlemen. How are you doing?
I'm doing excellent.
Yes.
Merry Christmas.
Hey, Crow. And hey, Christmas, Martin.
Yes.
Hey, Geo.
Hey, brother. Happy
Merry Christmas to everyone that watched this in 2 days.
Yeah, happy Easter. Yeah,
Geo's making us feel Christmassy now. Yes. Happy Easter.
Yeah. Well, it's good to see you again, or to hear you again. Big welcome.
Yeah, you too, man. Arnie.
What? Sorry?
Arnie. Arnold Schwarzenegger.
Arnie, I'll be back.
Stop it. It's funny, I still get comments like that every day. Almost every day I find a YouTube comment that says, is that Arnold Schwarzenegger? Question mark. It's funny.
I don't really sound like him at all.
I don't understand it also, but it must be true because the amount of comments I got is insane. So there must be something to it.
Hey, I had a question for you guys. It would be perfect for you guys. Since you guys are overseas, I was wondering, what do you guys think of our new president, Donald Trump? What are they talking about there?
I don't know what to think. Well, most people here don't like him at all because the media is saying bad things about him all the time. But me personally, I have some hope. I don't know if he's legit or not, but I think if he means what he said, all the 100 things he wants to do, most of them I agree with. There are some things that I don't like, but most of them I highly agree with. So I think there might be some change because of him. Well, that's what I hope. And I think he really starts to change all the things that he says, other countries are going to have a big problem. They're going to have to follow, or they're going to have to just do the opposite. then it's going to be basically war, probably. Who knows?
Hmm.
But I don't know if it changes things and things are going to improve. The other countries will probably follow. So Europe will have to follow.
Mm-hmm. I see him as a car salesman.
But one more thing I want to say, maybe he's controlled totally.
Yes. Yeah.
I mean, he would have to be. I mean, there's no way they're just going to let him free roam around that White House like he owns it.
Well, why I have my doubts is because he has a lot of money and you can do a lot with money. So maybe it's possible that someone with a lot of money that is not in the team or in the group.
Can buy themselves a presidency. Yeah. It is true. It is true, Gio.
That's why I have my doubts.
He could be outside of that corruption. He's
crazy. In some ways.
Draining the swamp might be a reality, Gio. He may do it. What he's saying.
But in The Simpsons, he made the country go bankrupt.
All right.
maybe it's predictive programming.
Yeah.
Maybe.
I think it's good that he's not a politician by definition, but it's not great that he's a philanthropist?
Philanthropist, yeah.
Yeah. Businessman, tycoon. I don't think that's a great substitute.
True.
They say that, usually the elitists don't let things happen unless they want it to happen. So there must be a reason why Donald Trump is the president.
I know why. Because he looks like the guy on the Illuminati cards.
It would be easy to, rig the polls to whoever they want to be, the president. So, he barely won. I mean, it wasn't like a huge landslide. So,
yeah. Well, they called in the British press 2 days ago about that, though, the election. They were saying that something to do with the Russians are saying that he's pro Putin, aka somewhere along the line, Putin has affected the election process, as they were saying in the British press 2 days ago. So, I don't know whether they're edging for a revote. I don't think so at this late stage, though. That's all.
They are pushing that in the media also here, that Putin changed the elections or forced it to be Trump in some way or hacked the elections.
And Myrtle's been playing that song as well, been saying that it's definitely, they're saying the Russians had some say in it. Not sure, Gio.
Well, I think it's all the same kind of group of same kind of bullshit.
Yeah, all oligarchs together. That's all it is. Oligarchs together. The guy's a brilliant businessman, so he may be good for America for making money. Well, and that's what they're good at. So, for that sort of thing, he might be brilliant. But as for a commander in chief, and if there are nuclear weapons, that means he would have his finger on the button.
Today in mainstream media in Belgium, it's said that Donald Trump is going to make a lot more nukes.
Is that a reality? I haven't seen that. Oh, God, is it?
It showed some tweet of him, but it didn't tell me much. And the article seemed to push that it's something else. I don't know. It was kind of weird. But I don't worry about it. It just seems that the media is trying to give him a bad name all the time. That's how it seems.
Mm-hmm.
So maybe that really means that he's legit.
Yeah, that's what I'm just thinking. If he's still getting a post, maybe. Hope so.
Who knows? They can still stop him, or they can do a lot to try to stop him.
Yeah, but think about 2 days before the election when there was that apparent assassination. Now, you wouldn't be able to get in close to a presidential candidate with a gun. They'd be from, giant magnets or metal detectors going in, surely to God, you think.
Yeah.
And then he's got no trauma, no stress. 2 days later, he gets voted in as president. You'd think that the trauma of being shot at would give you some sort of shock, some after thing, where you need to probably have a lay down and nearly die, but nothing. And they never carried on with that story about this assassin. Haven't you heard nothing about it after? And I've looked. It's just really strange,
That's kind of weird, because I remember that,
So I thought
I didn't even know that happened.
I've looked. Russian vids videos. You know, 2 months back, and he posted about it. Some guy slagging him off first, and he shouts to him, "Oh, what are you, one of Hillary Clinton's employees? What did he, she pay you $1,000, did she? And then you hear like patter, 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 where he's shooting at him. And they
really?
Take him off.
Bloody hell.
Yeah, yeah, no. And he's really close to the front of the stage as well, see, Chris. This is, it just doesn't ring true, you know.
All how the did bodyguards, he miss?
How did he miss? Exactly. All the bodyguards sort of hustle him off. Like, that was a bit dodgy looking, you know, the lack of hysteria or the lack of, you know, he's just got it like they knew it was false. It was just, it's just not right. A bit like this recent assassination of the Russian ambassador by this apparent Turkish bodyguard. That stinks. That is wrong. That's rubbish. You would not stand there with a guy shooting with a camera in front of you. You know, it's like, well, death. You're not going to do it. It just doesn't ring true for a wage. It's just not reality. Have you seen that, Chris, at all?
Do you know what? I haven't really been paying much attention to alternative media.
I don't watch. I get my news from Peaky Truth and Russian Vids.
Recently. Yeah, I should really start subscribing and keep up. But yeah, Peaky's no, good. I missed that as well, man.
Yeah.
Peaky Truth and Russian Vids are two amazing channels.
Yeah, I love them. Love them both. So cool. Yeah.
Isn't some of Russian Vids stuff a little bit far-fetched, though?
Well, he's religious, so he goes into like fire and brimstone, doesn't he? So there'll always be that, you know, spice through it. Apart from that, he's awesome, awesome.
Well, what I think about it is he's making so many videos and saying what he thinks about so many things that he's probably wrong in a lot of cases. But I think in most of the cases, he's right on.
Yeah, he's as wrong as like Jungle Surfer is wrong in a lot of cases. Yeah. He's like, I watched a video this week where he said Ivana Trump was a little boy. And had a sex to me. And Ivana Trump, what, you mean the supermodel looking one? Hang on a minute. Well, Michael Obama, yeah, I can believe that. Venus Williams, yeah, I can believe that. Kate Middleton, no, I'm not so sure about that. Ivana Trump, no, Jungle Surfer, wrong. So, yeah, they chuck him out there. Oh, God. I know.
People in the chat are saying PK is awesome.
He is. I agree. He is. I asked to interview him, you know. He said, no, Martin. He said, I don't let flat earthers interview me. So I'm thinking of going back at him, I'm more of a neutral stance. He said he does like me, but he won't let me interview him.
Yeah, it seems that he's ignoring flat earth mostly.
I did not, but he's really, really nice and civil. He knows exactly who I am. He's just, don't like flat earth. So I thought for when a neutral stance.
But in his videos, or live events, he's ignoring it. But it might be a smart choice also for him, for the content that he releases.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah, but he went away for a while.
A lot, so Ali for a lot of people.
Yeah, some of these, they can't all be false flags, can they?
No.
All of them?
They can't.
Some of them must be real, Chris. Yeah,
there are crazy people out there that do horrible, nasty, violent, bloody,
but
disgusting things. They just are.
But it's pretty obvious to see which one are real because you can see so many articles and it's so obvious when something is real because you got all the video, all the pictures that show all the detail. Hey, Yika. Welcome, my man.
Hello.
But we have a like delay. I hope.
And now.
Fix it.
Okay, imagine.
Fix it and welcome.
How's it going?
Everything is going excellent for me.
Nice.
I hope the same for you both.
Everything is cool.
That's awesome, and awesome Christmas tree also. That's the cheapest one I have seen.
you have one also somewhere in your software.
Yeah, it's better than mine because I have none.
Yeah. You know.
I don't have a Christmas tree because I have a cat. She destroys it.
Oh, that's better.
Yeah, the echo is gone. Thanks.
Nice.
So it's filling up. Anything someone wants to talk about? Oh, Arwen is also here. Welcome.
Also here.
Hey, Arwen.
Hey, Chris. Hello, Geoshifter. You're looking a bit green today.
I'm inside of the Matrix.
I got unplugged
and stuff.
Hey, you know he's Neo. Arwen, he's Neo. Texas. You know that. He doesn't need eyes. I know, Arwen. Good to see you.
He's using his Matrix sight. Nice.
Wait, let me see what else I wanted to tell. I wanted to talk about the EM drive also. Does someone know the EM drive? Or did someone see my video about the EM drive?
Not me. What is it?
Let me screen share some stuff. Because I think it was in the media a while ago, but it seems that almost everyone missed it. Like, I didn't find much videos discussing it or talking about it.
I've been hearing from it for some time now. So it's something that I've been bringing up every now and then.
Yeah.
And now recently I saw this article where apparently the Chinese had this breakthrough. Ooh, ooh, ooh.
I don't know where to find it. Google is showing me all the Dutch results, but I'm not going to open Dutch pages.
What does... an electromagnetic generator or something.
Well, it's some sort of thrust device, a new sort of thrust device that they invented at NASA, and it breaks the laws of physics.
Oh.
And they claim that it can take people to Mars in like 1 month. Because it doesn't need much fuel or anything. I don't know what exactly or how it works. No one knows because no one can understand it. But, you know, it's kind of crazy that they can come out with articles like this and claim the law of physics and people think it's legit. Because you can find people on YouTube that are actually testing the idea.
I always laugh at that when the articles claim that, oh yeah, they just tested the drive and it really works.
Yeah, and there's a guy on YouTube doing it.
You never see any pictures.
It's invented like
light speed things. Like, oh yeah, they tested it. Yeah, it worked.
That's good enough for me.
Well,
so they're like now a big stain at the firmament somewhere or something, you know. Like,
there's some guy that invented this like 10 years ago or maybe 15 years ago already. But he didn't invent it, he just had the idea. So he came out with the idea without any proof of concept. So now, 10 years later, they claim it works. But all you can find is some guy on YouTube testing it, and he gets like 1 gram of thrust out of a big metal bucket. Makes no sense at all. So how can you go to Mars with 1 gram of thrust in 1 month?
Do you think this revelation would have anything to do with them declaring that they're going to go to Mars in the next 20 years?
Probably, yeah. Probably they will use this to go there.
Oh, well, about the thrust, Geoshifter, I could give a small globe head explanation for that. And that is that the idea about propulsion in vacuum is that it is supposed to work, apparently, but also that the momentum doesn't stop, so you keep on moving with whatever speed you're going, with nothing to stop you, so you
there's
need
no
very
resistance.
Little propulsion
yeah
power
indeed
to actually
I understand that, but then if you look into it further, you will see that they claim that it only works in space and that they didn't even test it yet. Still basically an idea, but now it got approved and they say, yeah, it's true, it's working.
Of course.
And then there's a guy testing it on Earth, not in space, and it gives thrust, so it makes no sense in any way.
It never does, it's always...
But probably they can use it now as a backup plan if like Flat Earth gets too popular or anything else happens and they need to increase the propaganda, they have a backup plan to go to Mars faster, maybe even next year, who knows. Because now they have the engine to do it faster.
Yeah, we're going to end up with the Let's Go to Mars reality show. sooner or later. With moon lander level quality props.
With the 15-year-old girl.
I think that's the plan, yeah.
And it's going to be so silly.
But they're never going to get it done because too many people are waking up, I think.
Yeah, still makes no sense anyway, in theory, because space moves as well, doesn't it? That's how the hyperdrive on Star Trek works. They reckon that the ship actually stays in without motion and space moves around it. And then that's how it gets to its point. And space, they say, is all moving.
It's relative. All moving in all directions.
In all directions, yeah. So they've got to put that into the equation as well. But they always leave that out, don't they? And the vacuum. The sucking nature of the vacuum.
It's funny stuff, NASA.
It is. I have no idea what's up there whatsoever. I would love to know.
Has anybody seen the new Star Wars movie?
I got it. I got it to watch. Arwin, yeah? Is it worth me watching?
I've heard a lot of good things from it, the story-wise at least. They've been improving a great deal on the storytelling quality overall. And, well, I thought the special effects were really impressive last time. I was very convinced about the globes and everything. It was really awesome. And they're probably going to continue this. And I heard from some people that are real big Star Wars fans that they were especially grateful that they upscaled the battles, the space battles, even more larger Lord of the Rings
leading up to the point of, do you know the first Star Trek, the one in 1977, when Luke Skywalker's village is all burnt out and all that? Well, this film is supposed to be leading up to that point.
In between Star Wars
that's it. Four. Be interesting, I suppose. I'll watch it.
I thought the last one was crap. I'm sorry.
You seen it?
Yeah, not the one that has just been released, but the one last year. Yeah, I went with my stepfather to the cinema. I mean, it was okay, but it wasn't spectacular. I much preferred. I can't remember the name of the film now, but
Star Wars 5.
There was one. No, there was a film released a couple of years ago, what's his name? Michael Caine was in it, and they said that they'd been faking going to space, and this guy, I can't remember the name, Interstellar, that's what it was called.
Oh, yeah, such an impressive movie.
Yeah, I much preferred that. I thought the new Star Wars, considering the budget difference, it wasn't spectacular in comparison.
Interstellar got the whole time differential thing. That's what they got so right, and they really gave the feeling of the exploration of the new planets, like for the first time ever on screen. I was so impressed, especially back then, because I was still dreaming about the globe. So yeah, it was such a big impact to me.
Yeah, great film.
Yeah, I love the story.
There was a really good the way they portrayed the relationship he had with his daughter as well was very, very believable, very real, very emotional.
Yes. Yeah, especially the part when he went through the time differential and came back and then had to watch that tape of 80 years.
Yeah.
Family man, that was so, and they picked the right music too, you know, so. It's a big, big important part about all science fiction is they have to pick the right music. And then it works. It just works.
Yeah, it's really good that. Enjoyed that film.
Yeah. But it's science fiction. It's not real. It's make-believe. As we all know, the Earth is flat and nobody's been up there. It's all in our minds and in our computers.
Yeah.
Yeah, I didn't see the movie, but I played Star Wars a while ago, the game.
I also saw that one, it was like with the virtual reality thing on the PlayStation 4, somebody was playing it, and he had a VR helmet on, and he actually was in a TIE fighter in some space battle, too. That looked really interesting, yeah. He was talking like, oh yeah, this is my childhood dream coming true, and yeah, it really looked that good. So
science fiction like is still cool, yeah. But when you know about the flat earth, everything changes, but still it's cool in some way.
Yeah, you know what? Who wants to go out in some kind of bucket inside of the absolute nothing
vacuum
where your blood will boil into gas as soon as something leaks or anything, you know? You know what? Yeah. No thanks. I prefer it here on Earth where it's safe.
Yep.
And motionless.
That's why space is a good way to hide more land. Because no one wants to go there.
Indeed. It's like the sea, but even worse.
Yeah. The sea, without anything.
What are you saying, Geo? They're hiding more land in space.
Yeah. Well, who knows?
They use space to hide more land.
Well, who knows what is really up there?
They use nothing to hide more land because space is nothing. So maybe there even is no more land.
Well, we just believe in anything they tell us. We go, you know, one theory for another, you know, and either the blood boils because of the Van Allen belt, or it's the vacuum, or it's one thing and another, and it's all just from them. We have no idea.
That's exactly the problem, that we just go with whatever they tell us.
Yeah.
Until you start to think about it, and that's the problem. Most people just don't think about it. Because
it might be okay,
they are a child, they just, well... A child always believes everything, so when you grow up and you learn all the stuff like that, so easy to brainwash a child.
Yeah. I had this conversation with my nephew yesterday, give me this stupid ass, oh, what happens when the water runs off the edge then, Matt? Well, I wouldn't go there with him with that, because I can't answer that stupid ass question. So that just makes me, I can't listen. But he said, look, so you can't, you're saying to me that you don't believe that the moon and the stars and the planets, our globes, our balls. I said, when I showed him a photograph that I took of Venus, showed him a close-up, and I said, why do you think that that is a globe or a ball or a planet like they tell you? Because this is what I'm showing you, and it's just a fuzzy light. So they give us of these beautiful, pristine orbs or globes. He said, yeah, because they are. I said, you haven't seen them, have you? No. So why do you believe? Because the pictures... it's just a hopeless scenario with some people. They will always go back to the pictures that they have seen. I tried to explain, but you just wouldn't get it.
Yeah, but it needs time also. You need. It was the same for me, you know. If you asked me 15 years ago, I would probably react the same. So
yeah,
it takes time to wake up someone. But every time when you say something like that, it will make them question slowly and... But well, yeah, some people will never wake up. Probably.
I tried to explain, but he just tried to explain. Look, I'm seeing craters on the moon with my naked eye, and my eyes are really bad. And the diameters are only like 20 miles in diameter or 30 miles in diameter. The biggest is 86 miles in diameter. Tycho, why am I seeing them with my naked eyes when it's a quarter of a million miles away? But. You know, the atmosphere could act as a lens, and you don't know what the properties of the distance are of the vacuum. No, that's just fucking rubbish. So, you know, it's a really difficult argument with some people. I got to be honest, really. You couldn't see what I was trying to say, basically.
That's why YouTube is so awesome, because you can just say what you think, and if people don't agree, they can just click away, and it doesn't matter. If you just wake up the ones that want it, that's awesome, you know. That's what I love about YouTube.
Hooray for freedom of speech, everyone.
Big welcome to Isa.
Close as you can get. Isa Mahal.
Hey, Isa.
No audio, I think. We will give him some time because... We don't have audio from you.
Yeah, but no sound here, Isa.
Welcome anyway. So, what were we talking about?
I got a hurricane coming tomorrow, Hurricane Brenda. So we got to batten down the hatches, or hatten down the batches, because it's going to be pretty bad, they say, for Christmas too, Christmas Day. Yes, Isa Mahal? No volume, brother.
Nope, still muted. Nope.
not working, maybe because it's on mobile, maybe connection. I don't know.
No.
Video seems to be
he's probably
fine.
Muted.
I don't know so much about these hangouts. But I don't see any muting on his icon. Anyway, cool, he's here. He will probably fix it.
He will.
Seems to be somewhere in space.
Yeah, I was going to do a Venus shot earlier. It's really bright when it gets really high. And I only remember it in the morning and the evenings for about an hour or so, and now it's visible right into the night. So I don't know what's going on. Things have shifted from my observations of the sky and I've been doing this since childhood. Things are not the same up there as they were. Do you know that?
That's why Pluto is not a planet anymore.
Yeah, spend 10 years debunking it to a dwarf planet and then go there. Does that make sense? The furthest body in the solar system, the astronomical distances, and they sent signals back. Pristine. And with Pluto on the side. The Disney one.
And perfectly cut round CGI corners.
Yeah. And still people believing. I know. I know.
You're round.
The yes. Disney one, yeah. NASA has been releasing a lot of pictures of globes since the flat Earth got popular. And you remember when they posted those pictures of frying pans?
Mm-hmm.
That was so insane. Like, they posted an article somewhere with six pictures from the bottom of like old frying pans, and it looked exactly like planets. And then they said some title like, find which one is the real planet. Just to mock us, man. It's insane.
Yeah,
so it's NASA proving that you can make planets with frying pans.
Yeah. I got some books to show me Venus as being actually blue, and other books to show me as a red fiery inferno. And they actually tell us they've landed a probe. I got a photograph. They said it went through the atmosphere, it lasted 11 minutes, and then fizzled up with the extreme pressures. And they've got like a photograph that they managed to beam out of these extreme pressures. Back to it.
Let me guess, it took a selfie also, probably.
Yeah, you know the fucking story. It don't make no sense, none of it. The more you think into it, it just gets laughable. It really does. And the camera, there's always a cameraman hanging around in space. Don't forget him. He just, his job is hanging around in space to take photographs. Yep, of any passing satellite.
That's a camera satellite. Matthew Boylan explained it.
Yeah.
They always send a second satellite right behind it to take pictures. That's how they work.
Well, that's not how they explained the Cassini. And the Cassini images were, they didn't send two up with that. And the images were of Cassini going past Saturn. Nobody ever wondered about that. I was always wondering why nobody wondered. I was actually a globe believer back then.
And also the Mars rover can take selfies. And then when you look it up, they explain it with like it takes 50 pictures or something and then edit it so that there is no arm, so that the arm is invisible.
Yeah, it's not the best place for them. Like, I was looking into this early on, why they landed in the Gale crater. And apparently the Curiosity rover is climbing up the Gale mountain. It's going to take X amount of years for it to get up there, right? Now, why didn't they land in, say, Sedona and show us the face of Sedona and all these apparent civilizations and pyramids that are all supposed to be up in the northern half of Mars then, or Maris Ferenaris or Olympus Mons, all these cool stuff that we're supposed to be really there, we can have a look at. But no, Gale crater down the bottom by year, nothing much happening. It makes no sense. It doesn't make sense.
The Earth is covered in pyramids. It's everywhere, in the sea, on the land, everywhere, in the mountains.
Yeah, I got some wicked photographs, undersea ones, off Japan in the Bay of Cayman. Yeah. And the Chinese, they don't let you look at theirs, though, Arwen, but they got a lot, the Emperor Qing not there.
No,
they keep them...
Diving for them. I've seen very good-looking photos. Sure,
yeah. Huge staircases.
Yeah. Just
monumental.
To see.
Yeah.
Like coral-colored water around it.
Mm-hmm.
Wasn't that deep even.
What does that make you think, that there was ancient civilizations further back in time that are flooded? Is that what you think is going on?
It's full of it. It's. By the way, some of you may have heard some of the, about this, but I've been building on a creation story bit. I shared it with some people, and it includes the periods in history as I've been trying to figure it out from everything that I've come across, from all the biblical perspective and the no trees video and all that following, and everything basically. Some the more other strains. Yeah, I've been listening to Jay Dreamers also.
Oh, yeah.
Has very interesting ideas. So yeah, I've been putting it all together and trying to figure out just what has happened. A lot has happened, and it's very complicated, and it seems to be getting more complicated as time passes. And yeah, I hope you guys like it. I've already written the script basically, and even recorded it speaking myself, and it's like 24 and a half minutes.
Cool.
But I have no video material for it. So
where can people find it on your channel?
Yeah, I haven't put it out yet, but if you want, I can give it to you. I can just share it on Skype. I have no problem with it. And
yeah, that's cool, but you should give it to as many as possible, I think.
Yeah, but the thing is, I really want eventually to be a video of there, but I have to get the right pictures together, and like 25 minutes worth of pictures, you know, is, and I want the pictures to fit also like how the story progresses. Because it's like all the different periods of Earth, and it looked very different.
And it takes a lot of time to make a video, yeah.
Yeah, it's gone. Well, I already finished the story now, and I'm pretty satisfied with it so far. Although, yeah, I haven't had much criticism of it because I haven't shared it with everyone, of course. But yeah, getting the pictures together, that is difficult because, yeah, well, because of like how. What I'm trying to portray, it's very specific in what it's about. So to find the right pictures is going to be quite a chore, and it's not my biggest talent to find them. Some people are really good at finding pictures, but not me, not so much. Anyway, yeah, anyone who wants it, just message me. I'm Arwin, and I'll share it with you. I'll share it with you on Skype, no problem.
Cool, man.
Arwin, just out of interest, how far back do you think verifiable history goes that you could say at least loosely trust upon?
Wow. Well, that's the whole thing, you know, verifiable. That's the whole problem, because, we've all come to learn to lean upon, well, science approaches on measuring things, and that's how we estimate pretty much everything. So there's the carbon dating, and there's the concept of fossilized things and the layers on the Earth. But yeah, how real is all of this? So verifiable, it's very, very hard to say, but I think probably the hard line Christian idea is pretty close, like 5,500 years, but it could be more. Even in my story, I had a pre Adam and Eve period, so it could be longer. It's very hard to tell. But hey, I'm not a historian. I'm like I put this together as an artist, so. I'm not claiming to be biblically correct and everything. I'm trying to build it, and not to bump into many things that are out there. But we'll just see how it goes.
Yeah, man.
Yeah, I've been working on this project for over a year now, so it's been laying there just in the distance for a while.
Do you think there was a flood, Darwin? Do you think this is? Do you think there was pre-Vanuvian civilizations then? Yeah.
Sorry.
Do you think there was civilizations that got wiped out by this biblical flood, or the one that there is evidence for? Yeah.
Yeah, I think there's a specific period in my story. I call it the Age of Cataclysm, and defined by two separate cataclysms. First one is one of fire. I say. It's like the fire and brimstone one. And then the second one is a flood. That's not too far after that.
I'm confused maybe with it all because, you know, Grey Man Cop goes with, like he says about 12,000 years ago was the end of our ice age. And some people are giving 8,500 as the date of this, of the biblical flood. Now, I can't work out which has come first and which would be more impactive. Did the ice age even actually happen?
That's pretty interesting.
Yeah, it is, isn't it?
But yeah, I think that probably the flood came first and then the ice age, because there's, of course, a lot of water. This water would reflect a lot of sunlight. So that would probably cool off a bit because there's no ground to absorb all the heat of the light. Perhaps
you may be onto something. That's not bad speculation.
But who
actually
knows? That could have triggered an ice age, and then eventually the ice caps kind of broke open or whatever. Some parts melted. Well, who knows? Maybe
I'm in two minds.
It could be that this flood has shaped the world as we know it. That it has caused these ice caps everywhere, and perhaps the puddles in between. If that is actually how it looks, it could be.
I've looked into the ice age. The evidence for it is limited. They say that the British Isles are springing back even today, which causes some seismic activity from when the ice cap was on it. Now, it didn't actually reach as far south as where I am now. It stopped about 11 miles north of me, the ice wall that they say happened at the time. I've got books about this. So there was an ice wall at that time. Anything north of there was under ice. You know, so that's all of Scandinavia, Scotland, Northern England and the rest. Now, they say when all this water receded, it carved out glacial valleys, yes?
And the whole northern land.
Yeah, so the landscape.
Or the mountain ranges.
Yeah, or everything we see today, yes? Like that. Right? So they say that when a glacier moves back, it leaves a trail. It picks up stones, giant stones, small stones, and it literally, as it recedes, it dumps these stones on the landscape, okay? Yes. Now, they say that the evidence for this, right, was disposed of in the 1700s, aka apparently a load of farmers got out there, they lit fires under these giant stones, smashed, and then poured water over them, cracking them and smashing them into smaller stones so that they could reclaim it for farmland. Now, that's the only evidence that I've got that anything like this existed. There's a whole load of big stones missing from the glacial deposit, so the story don't fit and don't work. So I'm skeptical about the ice age. That's just me, though.
Well, there are
political hillbilly.
Oh, sorry, Josh.
There's no problem. I just wanted to say hi because political hillbilly joined.
Oh yeah,
hey. That's awesome.
Thank you. Nice. You guys have a nice hangout here.
Hey, Scott.
Go on, you can keep talking. Sorry to interrupt.
Yeah, about the ice age. I think the idea that there's been big ice caps that have pretty much crossed through like half of Europe and everything. I don't know if it ever went that far, or that might be still something to come, but. Ice periods have been definitely recorded. There's the miniature ice age. There's even been many.
Oh yeah, the Middle Ages ice age. The Thames frozen over there. The market. You're quite right. Yeah.
Yeah, but yeah. Even bigger ice caps closing in, like in the distance, that kind of scenery. So there's many paintings that there have been very icy periods, although not the The whole idea of a large ice cap that would have destroyed the landscape, as it were. There's, I don't know, could be, maybe.
And then the flood, killing everything and flooding everything. And they say, where did all that extra water come from?
In the time of the flood, everything was very different because it was still, the whole place was littered with giants everywhere. And there were still,
there's still no actual positive evidence for that, really.
I'm very convinced that they were there and they're still here. There are probably a lot of them back then.
Do you think there are still giants right now somewhere? Yeah, I think the same.
You watch.
I've been meeting some very tall people in my lifetime. So.
Yeah, but I mean really giants, not like 3 meters or something, but like massive.
The 25 meters.
Like, yeah.
Oh, the colossuses, colossi, the really big ones.
Yeah.
Who knows?
So different ponds, maybe. I mean, maybe.
Yeah, and maybe they're subterranean. Because there's still the whole hollow earth thing.
They could be chocolate dogs.
Calling it hollow would suggest that it's a globe, but like the subterranean, the...
Not necessarily, no, Harry. Why does it have to have a globe for an inner earth? We don't know what's below us. Have no idea.
Shale. Zip. It's shale. Called shale.
Flat, but it's an illusion that makes it look hollow.
Yeah, they just like to call it hollow because it more suggests the globe. So... they're sticking with the word because of the inclination. But yeah, it's just the world underneath us, underneath the rock, basically. And there could be a lot of creatures in there. Who knows? Giants, could be elves in there. Or who knows? The Nazis have taken over, you know?
I'm an elf. I'm an elf. I've been told by another elfling creature. She said, oh, another elfling creature. It's been years since I met one. How are you, Martin? You see my ears, are we?
Yeah. Yeah, me
don't
too.
Don't tell everyone, all right? Yeah, no. Don't tell everyone. Don't tell anyone.
I'm probably a troll.
Nice one. Get back under your bridge. That is sad.
It's nice to be with elves.
Yeah, we're magical. Well,
I think there might be giants beyond the South or North Pole, probably the North Pole. I think there's a lot more there.
I think both. I've settled for both.
I think there's the most chance, or we can find the most beyond the North Pole and not the South Pole.
Well, I think there is something very important at the North, anyhow you look at. So, but if there's still something alive over there, who knows? You know, they could have decided to just kill everything off there for safety or something. But let's hope not. That would be. Bad, but at the South, from what I've seen so far and all the ideas about it, and it's so much land there that who knows, it could be so big that it's just that it could be bigger than the continents that we know, and when it's so big, then anything could hide, you know, anything could hide there. Big things. There could be giant caves in there, and people wouldn't stumble upon them for thousands of years. Who knows?
Yeah. What's everybody's take on there might well be missing lands or missing continents within reaching distance of our current technology that isn't disclosed on any maps that is presented to the public?
Yeah, I'm into that, Chris. Definitely.
I think that's exactly what it is. Yeah.
We've seen both layers pretty much now. Like at the South and at the North, we've seen maps. There are maps out there already. They call them speculations and fantasies, but they're out there a lot. So those could be the first layers, and who knows, maybe there is even more beyond that. But like I like to say, if the world is a giant long ring or something, then each continent, each separate world would probably tell the others, hey, this is the last world. There's nothing beyond here. So that people would stop trying to get past them and use them as a runway. So who knows how many are out there?
Yeah.
We would never be told.
You know, I've been going into research of the eclipse, and now I'm going into research of previous past eclipse and future upcoming eclipse. Ooh. I'm coming to the theory that we can make a map out of the eclipse's past history.
Fuck yeah, I like that, Scott.
Yeah, I mean, we could already prove utilizing the eclipse that the Earth does not spin.
How far back do the documentations go? Up to the 1700s, is it?
Yeah, you can go back to the 1700s, and you can go all the way to the end of this century, too.
Okay, yeah.
You know?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
That's one of the reasons why I wanted to join. I got a small update to add to my eclipse research to prove that it doesn't spin. Excellent. If people don't mind. I don't mean to be changing the subject matter.
Yeah. I think we would all love to see that.
Okay, let me do a screen share then.
Yep, go ahead. I will present you.
Okay.
I will go back in the matrix.
Okay. Now pay attention. This map here is from the Astronomical Application Department, United States Naval Observatory, Washington, D.C. All right. Now, when you go to NASA's numbers will never match the map numbers, but all maps and the bogus animation definitely show this course. Now, I'm going to, here, let me hide this so I can zoom in on my buttons. Okay, we're going to zoom in on a starting point and a stopping point. See, here's 170 degrees west, so let's follow that line up as I pull it down. Starting point's just slightly west of 170 degrees west. So that's the starting point. Here's the ending point over here. Now, NASA will tell you that it ends on the 44th degree longitude, but as we can see the map here and all other maps where they got it laid out confirms this. Here's the 30th degree longitude west, and it's definitely to the east of it. So utilizing this map, going from 171 degrees to 28 degrees west, well, here's what it looks like on Google Earth. Using my path drawing skills here because I'm still getting used to it. But as we can see, hey, it's getting hard to fit that in there when we spin into it. Because remember, we spin 15 degrees an hour. It takes 5 hours and 19.1 minutes for this to make the path of totality from the starting point to the ending point. At 5 hours and 19.1 minutes, we spend exactly 9.751 degrees, meaning the ending point, this location in 5 hours and 19 minutes after the start, when it starts over here, this location should have spent clear over here to 52 degree east.
Yeah, tell you.
So if the Earth spun, that would be the location of 28 degree north, or 28 degree west, 10 degree north, would be 52 degrees east, 10 degree north. Person, you add the 5.5 hours of spin. That the globers can. These are their numbers. They're the ones that say that we spin 15 degrees an hour. Well, once you throw that spin in there and then you subtract the numbers, it just does not add up.
Nice research, man.
Very.
Trying to win the $5,000 NASA Eclipse Challenge.
Yeah. So for the upcoming eclipse in February 2000, or is it April 2024? Yeah, April 8th, 2024. Now that path of totality is going to go direction. Already seeing a problem from the starting point to the ending point, we're having to swing Mexico over to the left just a little bit. So I honestly think if we used the eclipses, past and present, we could honestly build us a true map. And here's the ironic part. The individual, I didn't catch his name, first time I ever seen. Nice to meet you, by the way. Gosh darn it. On one of my pictures, talking about making things bigger. You got the Arctic Circle being bigger. just a little bit, but it is. And I don't know, some people remember, we do spin in that direction. This is twilight over here. You got to stop and think. We're only, let's see here. Let me show you, by the way, now this is for the little country in Guinea, Africa. Let me scroll out here to show. Come on. Okay, it's for August 2017. The eclipse is on the 21st. Day length, 12 hours, 23 minutes. So that means that there's an extra 4 degrees from 180 degrees. Well, 4.5. So it'd be 4.5 degrees extra to 180 degrees being exposed at the 10th degree latitude. So that means I would have to take 2.5 degrees to, or 2.25 degrees of that and add it to the east, and 2.25 degrees and add it to the west. No matter whether you use NASA's numbers or use the map numbers, there is no way that the Earth can be spinning and cover that much territory that they say it's going to claim. This is not my claim. This is their claim. This is, look, they even tell you, as we zoom in, it starts at dawn. Starts at sunrise. Ends at sunset. Well, according to the image I just showed you, sunset's like sunset is at 7:10 p.m. on the 10th degree latitude on that day. Well, they're 10 time zones away from the starting point. They're 10 time zones away. I mean, the globe's got a serious problem when it comes to the spinning globe, anyways. Has got a problem when it comes to the path of totality. Because like I said, that from the time it starts, this spins 79.751 degrees in that direction. Right?
Yeah.
Well, actually, we spin in that direction, which would make the dark point over, but you guys get what I mean, right?
Yeah, that's pretty crazy. There's so much things that just don't work.
If you that's their figures, isn't it? God.
You throw it on a globe, longitudes and latitudes on a globe, it's hard to get them all in one exposure. And I'm right there, too.
Right, it shows me that they skew the map in some way, or that's how it looks.
Okay, my starting point is...
Because I don't think it would make a bet like that.
170 degrees. Latitude.
Yeah.
And my ending point is... 30 degrees, just slightly north of 10 degrees north. Just like their map. When you zoom out on it, you can't even hardly get it in. And that's with no spin at all. This takes place over 5 hours and 15 minutes. How far did that location spin in that direction? They're busted.
Again.
Yeah, let's see. Where's my screen share? Shut this off.
That's cool. I see you managed to make the bets in Google Earth.
It's not quite accurate. I'd like to have somebody give me a crash course on Google Earth, or I'd really love to get somebody on AutoCAD. There's two or three different things I'd like to do on AutoCAD. That's one, get my MSL C-level argument across where it's unarguable. For that, I need three-dimension capabilities. I got a little bit of animation skills, but I don't have no 3D skills.
I can do a bit 3D, but I just don't have the time to do it. Time is always a problem.
I can prove beyond a shadow of a doubt by reading sea level the way we do in the form of measuring it for construction, surveying for bridges prior to it. You know, there's a reason why we can go from a swampy wooded area to 1 year later having a shopping mall in that same location.
Yeah.
That's because everything done there was done with a control or a control point. That control point is sea level, means sea level. That very control point can prove that all water everywhere measures flat.
And at the same level, just like the word says.
Yeah.
For me, currently, the biggest concern with all maps is the whole grid system, what we're looking at. Because it seems that no matter what model you approach, there's always these size differences with everything on the globe and on the flat maps. And there is a big problem because we should see like each part of all the lands. We should just know how big they are with the internal distances and then compare all of that land, all of that, triangulate with everything. And that would probably yield the best result. And how would you show an Earth like that with a grid where each square is the same size? How would you do that?
It depends on how they made the grid, you know.
Yeah, because it's now based on the direction of the North Pole, of course.
The grid system is done on acreage. Each square is done on a similar acreage. I was told that all squares were the same acreage, even the small triangular bits on the top of the globe. Yeah. If that was a fact, then it would be indeed 100% proof that it was a...
Well, it's making me think that maybe there is this... there is an argument for portraying the world in the typical encyclopedia shape, I guess, of the flattened... round world. Only it's still, the squares are still all malformed because of this. So how do you get them all to get the same size and the same shape but still be in one map? That's the big trick. How do you do that, and how would it look? It would probably not look very two-dimensional, I think.
The true dimensions of the north of the Arctic Circle, and what's missing.
It would be all
there.
Wobbly, I think, or something. It wouldn't be flat. Like,
I have some real NASA software. Look.
Oh, wow.
Oh, with satellites. Oh, yeah. See, they're real.
It's now 2 minutes real per second. CGI, you can,
so
like,
be real.
This is real time, so you can track everything, but you cannot zoom in farther. And also the globe looks pretty crappy.
Eyes on, yes.
Yeah, it's pretty crazy. It's somewhere free to download from a NASA propulsion laboratory.
Of course.
But I don't know. I don't remember where exactly I downloaded it, but it's pretty funny. Like, this is supposed to be real time, but... The clouds don't move, oh no. But what I learned about this, if you look at all the things like global temperature and stuff, carbon dioxide, oh no, we're gonna die, unless we're in Antarctica.
doesn't exist there, I guess.
Carbon monoxide. That's okay. Here's sea level. This is sea level. Political hillbilly, you are wrong. You see, this is the real Got sea it. Level. They probably mean the depth. I hope they mean the depth.
They can't argue datum sea level or mean sea level. You know, it's etched in stone over in the Black Sea.
Unless you're places, on the globe.
What was it, Crown Vic or someplace in England, they got it marked. Been established since 1919, has not been altered since. So as we use numbers, that hasn't been altered for close to 100 years coming up. As we use those numbers, and that base number is zero, proves we are flat. That zero number never changes.
Yeah.
Yep. Could you just go back to the water and ice one? Yeah, that one, that looks like one of the program writers has, like, I don't know, let one of his kids on to play around with the saturation and depths. That looks really silly.
I think he took some really bad drugs and was going insane on this.
No, I think it's represented as a graph. So if something's really hot, so. It's down, and if it's really cold, it's up.
But I was trying to find the ISS, but it seemed, oh yeah, here it is. The ISS in real time. Go look outside if you live here. Go outside right now and go look if you can see the ISS. Take a picture, upload it, and post it in the chat. I'm waiting. This stupid software. Sorry, that was it. Anything else we need to discuss? Because I think I'm going to stop it pretty soon. I have no idea how long the Hangout is going, but I was not going to do it for very long.
Oh, yeah, guys, about holographic flat Earth. Have you heard about my idea that... I thought of, just came spontaneous to me about the holographic nature of the sun and what could prove it. And then I thought, rainbows. Because when you see a rainbow, it's basically the sunlight reflecting onto the water droplets. Then you get to see this beam, this, like a bow. But when you move, it moves with you. So it's holographic in nature. See? Yeah. It just moves with you. That's what makes it holographic. And I think that because of this, I think that rainbow is yet another proof that the sunlight itself is holographic. Because the rainbow comes from the sunlight. And yeah, if because it is holographic, then the sun must also be holographic.
You can't drive to the start of the rainbow or to the end. Did anyone ever try it?
Yeah, follow the rainbow and you find the pot of gold. But the thing is, whenever you follow it, it just moves.
It moves, I tried it one time and it kept moving. I kept like driving for like 30 minutes, but it kept moving. So.
But it's always the same distance. That's one of those typical things. And it's also one of the elements that Jason Laufenberg is following now with his footage, where he's convinced, look, it's the sun disk and the birds are flying through it. Well, it's still, you could think, like, is that really what you're seeing? But, well, if the sun is holographic, then it may be actually the disk that is there at that spot, and the birds just happen to fly in exactly the same spot. But to the birds, the disk would be at a totally different place because it's holographic. Where the sun is holographic. It's always relative to the viewer. It's always in the same spot.
Makes some sense, who knows?
Yeah, it's very weird, but it's also interesting. Anyway, holographic flat Earth, yay.
I can understand the idea. In theory, it could be possible.
Well, it could be tested. One of the most curious things that I'm most curious at is the test We also talked about this, me and Jason, about the whole sun rays coming from the clouds. You know, it disperses. It was one of the first proofs that Flat Earth came up with. Like, look, the sun is really close, If it's really that far away, millions and millions of miles or light years or whatever away, then the light should all be in one direction coming through the clouds. But you get to see all these photographs with the sun dispersing. But does it really always look like that? If you're looking at the clouds and you see this, does somebody else a few miles somewhere else, like ahead of you, and if he would look at those same clouds that you're looking at, that the suns are dispersing under, would he see the same thing? Would he see the same rays there coming under it? That's what I'm wondering. Or would he see the sun at a totally different spot? Maybe rays would come out of the clouds in another location from where he's standing. No, it would be a very interesting experiment to do, I think.
Yeah, and a possible one. Can be so difficult to test it, so.
Yeah, you have to really have the right kind of day, you know, where the sun is bright and the sky is clear, but there's still some clouds around. Because if it's all cloudy, then yeah, there's no sun. And if it's all sunny and there's no clouds, then yeah. So you have to have the right kind of weather to test it. Maybe this spring we'll get lucky.
Yeah, with cell phones and like people having internet everywhere right now.
With mobile phones indeed. So people, if you're out there and you see this very special sun coming through the clouds, if you see it, film it. Just whip out your phone and film it, put it on the net, and who knows, maybe somebody else in your same town or your same city also did it, but from another location. Then you could compare the footage. You could compare, like, hey, are you seeing the same thing at the same time?
I got one on my channel where I even go over my, they go over my head, and you can watch them diverge and then converge as they go past my head to pass the 90 to point and start going to the east. You can actually see it. Yeah. Pretty sharp.
Yeah.
Hey, I'll go ahead and excuse myself. People, if you want to follow my research on as I refine it on the eclipse, just watch out for videos coming up on my channel there, because I'm going to share it, because I got a theory about that sun. If I can get somebody to help me with the 3D modeling, putting solar noon where the sun where solar noon is at the point that the umbrum first makes contact with the Earth at the 171 degree. I don't think that you can draw a line and on a CAD machine end up 93. Well, actually, it should be 91 million miles away, or 91 and a half million miles away at this point. We're halfway in between our analemma, or not our analemma, but our perigee and our apogee stage. So we should be 100 or 91.5 million miles from the sun. And as we do the degree from where the sun rises, or degree of the sun where it hits at 171 degrees to due north of the Earth, then follow the node point of solar noon, those lines where they converge, that's where the sun's at. I bet money if somebody had capability of 3D machine or modeling, there's no way it comes even close to 90 million miles.
All those millions and millions of miles, it's all ridiculous. There's no millions on this Earth. There's maybe hundreds of thousands, perhaps, but there's no millions, never. I don't think it's anywhere.
What about light years?
That's even more ridiculous.
That's correct.
It's so theoretical. It's just self-explanatorily ridiculous.
Yeah.
So if there's anybody out there who'd like to help with 3D skills, man, sure appreciate you getting
I'll get my sniffers out there and see if I can find somebody. I do. People have approached me with 3D skills, so I just got to go back and have a look and see if I can dig them out for you. All right, Scott? See if I can find.
I appreciate it.
Yeah, man.
Can I ask, are you going to go?
Definitely.
Can I ask you one more question before you go, Hillbilly?
Yeah.
Are you still doing hangouts? Because I don't see any more from you lately.
I was going to, and I think somebody's got me talked into doing Sandy Hook hangout one last time. So if that goes good, I would be willing to do more Sandy Hook videos and Sandy Hook hangouts and Flat Earth. But something ironic. I don't really want to let the cat out of the bag, but I don't know how I can say this without letting the cat out of the bag.
Yeah. Yeah. Go back. No, go on.
Well, first of all, let me announce this. It seems that Charles at Flat Earth Math has been doxxed, okay?
Oh, and, what?
Yeah. Somebody tried to reveal his personal information.
Whoa. Oh, shit.
On my channel, he revealed it, and good thing that I run with hold comments for approval, so it never got released. Yeah. However, I haven't deleted it yet. Well, I'm a stout researcher, so just for excuse my French people, just for giggles, I just highlighted the address, searched it, and seen if the address is correct. It may have just answered a question, or anybody who knows my Sandy Hook research. As far as the official report goes, I hate to pat my own back, but I'm top scale, right? There's one question that I can never answer on Sandy Hook.
What is that?
I think the picture. I don't want to go into it just yet, you know. Hmm. But somehow the doxing of Charles got me to thinking of what I can't solve on Sandy Hook. So that's why I might do another Sandy Hook video.
That would be cool. I'm looking forward to that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because I didn't see any of your videos or hangouts in the last 2 or 3 months. So I'm wondering if it's YouTube that unsubscribed me for some reason or that you just didn't upload anything.
No. Well, the fun got pulled on my sail for a minute, you know.
Yeah.
I had to step away and take a break, and went caught up on some of my congressional watchdog reading legislation, because I did get way behind on that. Got caught up on the email cabasco, then about that time Pizzagate comes out, and boy, I'm really enjoying this research on the Eclipse, and anybody who's followed any of my research, whether it be the Patriot Act, 9/11, Ruby Ridge, Oklahoma City, they know that I'm a stickler for official words and details, and that's exactly what I'm doing with the Eclipse, destroying the Earth's spin.
That's cool. You're doing an awesome job.
Yeah, keep up the good work, everybody.
Yeah. Well, hey, gentlemen and ladies in the audience, people in the audience, you guys have a good holidays. Remember, if you want a good laugh, please go watch my 12 Days of Christmas for Flat Earthers video. It's a little corny, but by God, tell me you don't laugh.
It's awesome, Hillwood. It's awesome. I laughed so hard.
See, why did I miss that? I think YouTube unsubbed me from your channel or something.
It's hilarious. It's one for the books.
I will look it up later today.
We're gonna play it every year from now on, Hillbilly.
You have my permission to play it in here if you want, but other than that,
if you give me the link, yeah. If you want, I can play it.
Yeah. All right.
Unless it's like a 20-minute video.
Yeah.
But I don't know. I don't know if I can do the audio.
Oh,
I can screen share, but the audio, I don't know how to share the audio.
I probably do it once, but I got a lot of stuff open. It might lag the video a little bit, but let's see my channel.
But the Hangout is listed under comedy. So.
Flat Earth comedy, huh? Hey, people, I'm going to do a little Bill Nye the Science Guy roast. So I'm going to come off a little offensive towards flat earthers at first, okay? So bear with me. It's just a little devil's advocate before the egg gets thrown into Bill Nye's face.
Most of my subscribers don't like him, so.
Here's the link, by the way. Geoshifter in Skype.
Yeah, I switch my audio properties around. I'm about ready. I'll show it real quick.
Yeah, he can probably share the audio also. It's going to be better. But thanks for sending me the link. I think I have echo. But that's good. Means it's going to work.
Ah, you're going to play it? It's awesome. Cheers. The Golden Gate.
On the first day of Christmas, a glow star gave to me a globe grown in a pear tree. On the second day of Christmas, a globe star gave to me two lion apples and a globe grown in a pear tree. On the third day of Christmas, a glow star gave to me third rock the sun, two lion assholes, and a globe grown in a pear tree. On the fourth day of Christmas, a glow star gave to me creator of the fourth dimension, third rock the sun, two lion assholes, and a globe grown in a pear tree. On the fifth day of Christmas, a glow star gave to me five different fallacies. Creator of the fourth dimension, third rock in the sun, two lion assholes, and a globe grown in a pear tree. On the sixth day of Christmas, a glow star gave to me six fake moon landings, five different fallacies. Fourth dimension, third rotten sun, two lion assholes, and a globe grown in a pear tree. On the seventh day of Christmas, a glow star gave to me seven astronauts swimming, six fake moon landings, five different fallacies. Fourth dimension, third rotten sun, two lion assholes, and a globe grown in a pear tree. On the eighth day of Christmas, a globe star gave to me 8 inches of curvature, seven astronauts a swimming, six fake moon landings, five different fallacies. Creator of the fourth dimension, third rocking sun, two lion assholes, and a globe grown in a pear tree. In the ninth day of Christmas, a glow star gave to me ninth planet of barking, woof, 8 inches of curvature, seven astronauts of swimming, six fake moon landings, five different fallacies. Creator of the fourth dimension, third rocking sun, two lion assholes, and a globe grown in a pear tree. On the tenth day of Christmas, a glow star gave to me 10 irrational means of reasoning, 9th planet of barking, 8 inches of curvature, 7 astronauts of swimming, 6 fake moon landings, 5 different fallacies. Creator of the fourth dimension, third rock in the sun, 2 lion assholes, and a globe grown in a pear tree. On the 11th day of Christmas, a glow star gave to me 11, Liza Coriolis, 10, Erasmus means Reezy, 9, and Marky Moose, 8, and Kircher, 7, astronauts are swimming, 6, fake moon landing, 5, different fallacies. Creator of the fourth dimension, 3rd, rock in the sun, 2, lion assholes in a globe grown in a bear tree. On the 12th day of Christmas, a glowtar gave to me a 12-month calendar with 13 lunar cycles, 11 Liza Coriolis, 10 male rationalities, reason 9, now planet Marky Moose, 8, after curvature, 7, astronauts swimming, 6, 8, moon landing, 5 different fallacies. Traitor of the fourth dimension, 3rd, rock in the sun, 2, lion assholes, and a globe grown in a pear tree.
Nice.
That was awesome.
Good. Like this, please subscribe and give this video a thumbs up for more upcoming funny.
Yeah, please subscribe again. Well, please subscribe to Political Hillbilly, okay. And I'm gonna have to subscribe again, I think.
Yeah, this definitely made me subscribe.
Because I never saw this video in my list. And usually I don't miss many videos from cool flat earthers.
5 fallacies. Chuck Danny, that's cool.
That was awesome. There was someone in the chat that was saying that he's making the same kind of website that I'm doing. And his name is Flat Earth Friends. That's cool. I want to know where to find it so people can register on both websites. That's awesome. I reached 1,000 members on my website, which is insane.
Wow.
Without any promotion, you know, except for right now.
Yeah, your website is really crowded these days.
Yeah, I never promoted it. Only in like one video I mentioned it at the end.
Yeah, we have 1,032 members.
So fast. It's so insane how many people signed up and how many messages get posted wow. Right now every day.
We have 1,032 members and 11,045 pictures. Oh my god.
I'm getting some hackers also. They tried to take it down recently.
Oh really?
Well it was down for one day, but
yeah, what happened exactly? Who is this? Who is taking you down? Have you any hints of this?
I don't know who it was, but that it was a lot of IPs, mostly from North Korea. Well, I don't know, that's how it seems. But yeah, they tried to flood it in every possible way and kept refreshing constantly to try to get all the bandwidth so it goes down. And they managed eventually to get it down because I didn't notice that it was going on for the first like 12 hours, maybe 24 hours. And then it went down because the logs were too big and it filled up the hard drive. So basically because the hard drive was full. So I managed to fix it in like 2 hours or so, and it was up again, and the attack stopped.
Nice.
But I had a few things like that recently, so it seems that they are trying to take it down, but it doesn't matter because I have a few backup systems, and I'm even considering to rent a backup server now. So in case I get it down, I can just switch to the other one.
Yeah, do it, Gio.
Yeah, if you can, do it. Yeah, I love the site. I use it all the time. Every time I have something I want to share with the Flat Earth community, I always put it there first.
I forgot my password, Gio. I can't get back on it. I'm trying to, though. I need to go through the whole thing again.
Nora sent me a new password on Skype, and I will fix your account.
Oh, I will. Thanks, mate. I'll post pictures and stuff on that again. Then.
Yeah, but if there is another website to Flat Earth Friends, the other guy, send me the URL by email or something, because he probably cannot post it in chat. I don't know. I will make him moderator. Maybe I can post a link.
Hey,
that would be cool, because I would love to know if there is another website like that. Because if mine goes down, there is nothing anymore. So it there should be like 20 like that.
Yeah, hey, we'll go ahead and say it one more time. You guys have a good holidays. I'm going to take off. Martin, you tell Mrs. or Mother Martin, Merry Christmas. I hope you guys enjoy your holiday.
Just, Hillbilly just said, Chris. God bless you. Happy Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Thank you. Happy Christmas. Yep. Thank you. God bless you, brother.
Thank you. Ern, I forget what your name was, Ern, or what. Nice meeting you. And hey, let's not forget, if there's any Justin Bernard fans out there, Justin Bernard's a great contribution to Flat Earth community. He's scheduled to be home tomorrow. Merry Christmas. What a Christmas present for Justin. Other than that, everybody in text or in chat, you guys have a Merry Christmas too.
Cheers, Hillbilly.
Thanks. Same to you.
See you around.
I see you posted the link, but I see like no website on it. Basically some ads, and that's about it. Oh, maybe he's still building it. If you need help, you can email me.
Yeah.
But anyway, I'm gonna close the hangout. If that's fine for you both, or you three.
Yeah, man. Yeah, thank you, Gio. Thanks for having a hangout.
A great hangout, man.
Big thanks also. Yeah. It was fun. I was going to do a short one to everyone that watched. Have a good party at the end of the year. Thanks for watching. And
don't drink and drive, no one.
Big thanks to everyone in the hangout. See you soon.
Bye.